creating animations is your job or simply a passion or both. And you wondered, what else I can do to make my animations more interesting? I have a great technique that can change your output. Let me show you how to create the focus change effect. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will show you how to create the focus change effect in both render engines, Corona and Viri. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, let me show you what to do. Let me start by showing you where we are going. So in this video, I show you how to create this kind of effect. We'll start in having the focus on the chandelier and change it to the kitchen. So let's go back to 3ds Max. By the way, I'll be using the files from our animation training, so if you'd like to check it out, I put the link in the corner. I start with Corona renderer. Here is how the camera works. We have a simple, linear movement. It's visible on the camera object. You can see that the override focus value is changing over the time. Now, let me show you how to do this step by step. Let me move it away and start from scratch. Let's start by creating the camera. Go to Cameras and choose Corona Cam. I create a new camera and turn off the target. To do this, uncheck the targeted option. I set the camera view on the left-hand side to see what we are doing. First of all, let's move the camera up. I also move it slightly back. Let's rotate it. I'll do a couple of more adjustments to achieve a similar view to the previous one. It will help us to set up a nice composition. You can use the image comp helper to set up the composition. As we have our starting point of the camera set up, we can animate it. Let me show you. To do this, turn on the auto key option and choose the final frame. I will do frame 48. Next, I move the camera slightly to the left to the final position. So what we do now? We're animating the position of the camera. Let's check how it looks. We can turn on the play button. I think I need to adjust it slightly. I move it a bit to the right and rotate towards the center to create a rotation effect. Let's see. Nice. Let's change the animation and time to our final frame, 48 in my case. Then let's go to the middle of the composition and add the keyframe to the override focus value. You just have to change it and then change it back to the same value so it stays the same between frame 0 and 24. Then, I will go forward and add some variations so it looks like the camera is searching for focus. It will add a bit of imperfection. This is how autofocus works in some cameras. This step is optional though. Lastly, set the focus to the kitchen around frame 40. So you can see that here it stays the same. It changes value after it reaches frame 24. Let me show you how it looks now. I remove this keyframe, it's not necessary. I think I make a couple of adjustments here. Maybe I will move this to the left to make this changing of focus slightly slower. After you're happy with your results, turn off the auto key option. Then, let's go to the curve editor and smooth the curve. Find the override focus distance option and zoom in. Here is how the graph looks like now. Select the points and click this option. Here we go. It looks pretty smooth. We can adjust the curve to achieve desired effect. In this case, you cannot render an animation preview as it doesn't show depth of field. Now, the best way is to render frames in low res so you can see exactly how it looks like and if you achieve the desired effect. I suggest to render low quality render with white material override. So you can simply change the resolution to something pretty low, just to see the results. Now it's exactly the same in V-Ray, but I will show you how to do it. So if you are a V-Ray user, you won't struggle with this. This time, create a V-Ray physical camera and turn off the target. I align the camera to the camera cam to make it quicker, but you need to of course set it up by yourself. Turn on auto key. Move the slider to the last frame and move the camera to your final point. Here again, I simply align it. Turn off auto key. In V-Ray, you can see how strong the depth of field will be. Notice how these lines are changing if I change the F number value. Let's animate the target distance the same way as before. We'll be animated the target distance by changing values. Simply follow the steps. After you finish, go to the curve editor and make this point smooth. In the curve editor, you have to find the target distance option. I forgot about the keyframe here, so we can add it to the curve here. Okay, now select all and smooth the curve. I really like this effect. It gives really natural look, and I hope you will get a chance to add this effect to your next animation project. Thanks for watching. Also, if you want to know how to create outstanding animations, I'd like to invite you to check out our animation course. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!